proud. It is also a ceremony that both teaches and appreciates the Air Force military heritage. Drill is an integral part of the military history, a prominence that rests on the fact that its fundamental purpose was to prepare troops for battle. For the most part, drill procedures practiced in the past were identical to the tactical maneuvers employed on the battlefield. It was this aspect of drill which made it such an important part of training. Even today, drill remains a necessary and useful training activity for instilling discipline and esprit de corps. Over 220 years ago, General Washington enlisted the assistance of Baron von Steuben, a distinguished Prussian officer, to help instill discipline. Baron von Steuben arrived at Valley Forge in February of 1778, facing an army of several thousand undisciplined, half-starved, wretched men in rags. To correct these actions, he set to work immediately and wrote regulations designed to teach the discipline of drill to a model company of 120 selected men. Discipline became a part of the military for these individuals as they learned to respond to commands without hesitation. As they mastered the art of drill and began to work as a team, this group developed a collective sense of pride in themselves and in their unit. Watching this model company perform, observers were amazed to see how quickly and efficiently the troops could be massed and maneuvered into different battle formations. Later, members of this model company were assigned throughout the regular army to teach drill. It was through this simple emphasis on drill that the effectiveness and efficiency of Washington's Continental Army were improved. In 1789, Baron von Steuben wrote the American Army's first field manual, the regulations for the order and discipline of the troops of the United States. The drill procedures placed into effect at Valley Forge were not changed for over 85 years, and many of these same procedures from the 321st Training Squadron. Next is Blue Flight from the 323rd Training Squadron. In the center of the parade field is the 737th Training Group's Drum and Bugle Corps, Murray Flight from the 321st Training Squadron. The flight selected to carry our national, state, and territorial flags is from the 322nd Training Squadron, Airy Flight. Next are Roy, Cody, and Matthew's flight from the 323rd Training Squadron. The last four flights to pass in review today are from the 324th Training Squadron, Duprat Waldo, Harlow, McKinley, and Campanelli flight. At this time, please find a place to sit. Thank you, and enjoy today's ceremony.
Sure. Yeah.
Basic Military Training Graduation Parade. We would like to introduce our distinguished guests, beginning with the host for today's ceremony. The Commander, Air Force Basic Military Training, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas, Colonel William Fisher, accompanied by his wife, Janie. The Superintendent, Air Force Basic Military Training, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas, Chief Master Sergeant Chris Simpson. Today's reviewing official is the Commander, 2nd Air Force, Keesler Air Force Base, Mississippi, Major General Bob LaGruda, accompanied by his wife, Leslie. From the 37th Training Wing, the Commander, 37th Training Wing, have completed a demanding 7.5-week program that provides Air Force units throughout the world with trained airmen. Part of this training includes the time-proven concepts of military customs and traditions, which this parade is a vital part. All graduating airmen will also march over the Enlisted Heroes Walk. They will lead the way for thousands of airmen that will follow, all reflecting on our enlisted heritage, tradition of honor, and our legacy of valor. Our Commander of Airmen is Staff Sergeant Charles Bell, Military Training Instructor, 324th Training Squadron. General LaGruda will review today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the playing of the national anthem. Thank you. Please be seated. Trying to Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the playing of Ruffles and Flourishes. Thank you. Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating airmen passing in review today represent a portion of the 38,000 recruits who will complete basic military training this year. The 737th Training Group provides all recruits the essential military training to become motivated members of the enlisted corps of the greatest air force in the world. The military training instructors are responsible for the indoctrination, development, and discipline of the airmen. They have dedicated endless hours to ensure all training objectives are met. Today's graduates have proven through academic studies, military training, physical training, and the development of teamwork they are ready to take their place in the United States Air Force. The flights you will view today are a representation of the enlisted force. Each flight represents an enlisted member of the Air Force who has embodied our core values and contributed to its heritage. As our graduates turn left onto the bomb run to pass in review, they will march over the enlisted hero's walk. The airmen recognized on the pavers have been awarded our nation's highest honors, representing heroic and unselfish actions as members of the United States Air Force in armed conflict, including present-day operations in Afghanistan. They include 7 Medals of Honor, 26 Air Force Crosses, and 173 Silver Stars awarded for bravery during encounters with hostile enemy combatants. These enlisted heroes serve to inspire all airmen to execute their duties courageously with honor in their service to this great nation. Armed with a knowledge of our past, the airmen will exit the hero's walk by marching over a blue line, signifying their accession into the greatest air power in the world. Musical support for this morning's ceremony has been provided by the 737 Training Group's Drum and Bugle Corps, Murray Flight, and the 321st Training Squadron, performing today under the direction of Master Sergeant Sherry Wynn, hometown of Chattanooga, Tennessee. These airmen are also in basic military training, but have been hand-selected to perform the ceremonies at this time. We would like for you to notice our national, state, and territorial flags. If these flags pass in review, please stand and remember the appropriate courtesy of our national flag. Once the flags have passed in review, please, the courteous of others, be seated in order to allow Training Squadron, the Drum and Bugle Corps, representing Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force No. 14, Murray Flight, led by Master Sergeant Juan Garcia, hometown Cabo San Lucas, Mexico, and Technical Sergeant David Webster, hometown Baltimore, Maryland. The A Squadron Commander is Staff Sergeant Nathaniel Merrill, Military Training Instructor, 331st Training Squadron, hometown, Fort Belvoir, Virginia. from the 320th Training Squadron, representing Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force Number 6, McCoy Flight, led by Technical Sergeant Jasmine Davis, hometown Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
I'm gonna throw a third person over there. You know, when he sees that now.
From the 320th Training Squadron, representing Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force Number 7, Andrews Flight, led by Technical Sergeant Kevin Little, hometown Indio, California. From the 320th Training Squadron, representing Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force Number 8, Parrish Flight, led by Master Sergeant Brian Sickety, hometown Akron, Ohio. From the 320th Training Squadron, representing Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force Number 10, Fingston Flight, led by Technical Sergeant Danielle Siluano, hometown Fountain Valley, California. From the 321st Training Squadron, representing Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force Number 9, Binnaker Flight, led by Technical Sergeant Christopher Smith, hometown Sacramento, California. From the 321st Training Squadron, representing Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force Number 12, Vinken Flight, led by Master Sergeant Yanira Ochoa, hometown San Juan, Texas. From the 323rd Training Squadron, representing the Air Force Combat Action Medal recipient, Blue Flight, led by Technical Sergeant Andres Rojas, hometown Roselle, New Jersey. The squadron selected as the color guard is from the 323rd Training Squadron, led by Staff Sergeant Joseph Thompson, hometown Dayton, Ohio. The flights selected to carry our national, state, and territorial flags are from the 322nd Training Squadron, representing Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force, Number 1, Airy Flight, led by Technical Sergeant Angelo Tafoya, hometown Colorado Springs, Colorado, and Technical Sergeant Rene Riojas, hometown San Antonio, Texas. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. Texan tubes render a flying salute to our graduated airmen. These aircraft are from the 559th Flying Training Squadron, 12th Flying Training Wing, Joint Base San Antonio, Randolph, Texas. Seven and a half weeks, the airmen before you have transformed from civilians into motivated, disciplined warrior airmen with the foundation to serve in the world's greatest air force. Once these airmen leave basic military training, they will enter Airman's Week, where they will develop the critical thinking skills and further personalize their Air Force core values. They will continue on to technical training to learn the skills needed to perform in one of 130 Air Force specialties. They will then move on to serve at one of over 84 Air Force bases around the world or work directly with our sister services. As these airmen move on to technical training, they will continue to focus on adapting to military requirements, achieving occupational proficiency, and learning how to be highly productive members of the Air Force. These men and women will prepare for increased responsibilities and must ensure that they are trained, qualified, and ready to deploy and operate in an expeditionary environment while maintaining home station readiness. Of the hundreds and thousands of American citizens that enter the workforce each year, less than 1% have joined the ranks of the United States military, an even smaller percentage in the U.S. Air Force. You should be proud of their accomplishments thus far. The airmen before you have reached a milestone in their Air Force journey and will require your continued support to assist them in their future endeavor. These airmen in the future of our Air Force will have to pave the way for future generations of airmen as we continue to fly, fight, and win. We would like to take a moment to congratulate all of our Squadron Honor graduates, as well as their families. Basic military training honor graduates distinguish themselves by being ranked in the top 10% of all airmen graduating in their class. The exceptional personal dedication, integrity, service before self, and sustained excellence these airmen displayed throughout basic military training earned them this outstanding distinction. The airmen march forward for the oath of enlistment. We would like to thank the families and friends who are here in support of the airmen graduating today. Your words of encouragement helped motivate these airmen through 7.5 weeks of basic military training. On behalf of the United States Air Force and Air Force Basic Military Training, we extend our thanks to the many families and friends of America's airmen for the support of your airmen and the greatest air power the world has ever known. General Labruto will now come forward and address our graduated airmen. Woo!
Simply spectacular here in Military City, USA. And what we find time and time again is as you come from across the nation, you get a little taste of this great city and what they do for this wonderful community and what they do for all of us that have the opportunity to serve here, is that you decide to stay.
You know,
it's that good. And I'll tell you what, we couldn't ask for a more spectacular day to be able to do what was just done for our United States Air Force. With the backdrop of the American flag, with the incredible viewing stands and all of you that are here to celebrate. And I'll tell you what, how about your airmen, huh? What do you think of them? Lieutenant General Robertson's the Air Education and Training Command Commander, and what he likes to say, and what we all know, is that air power starts right here. That's what it's all about. That's our mission. And every single day, every one of us that wear this cloth of the nation understand the mission that we have is to support and defend. And we take that very, very seriously. On behalf of all of us, to the families that are here, the moms, the dads, the sisters, the brothers, the grandmas, the grandpas, the extended family that made your way to San Antonio to experience the first step into the Air Force, we want to thank all of you. We could not do our jobs without the love and the support of our families. We know that you're going to be behind your airmen every step of the way. And now your airmen are part of our Air Force. And all of us have a debt of gratitude to you, our American citizens, for contributing your sons and daughters. And believe me, we will take great care of them. Give it up for our families that are here today. And all of us that serve currently fully understand that we are standing on the shoulders of giants, men and women that have actually served our nation over the years. And so to all our veterans that are in the audience, would you please stand? Army, Navy, Marine Corps, Air Force, Coast Guard, everybody that has won the cloth of our nation, thank you for your service. Thank you for everything that you've done for our nation. And thank you to the families who sacrificed so all of you could serve. Thank you for being here. Finally, to Colonel Collins and to the incredible 37th Training Wing, and in particular, the men and women, the professionals that we call our military training instructors. Look at every single one of them. I'm going to tell you, this old general officer went on a diet for about 1 month to make sure that when I was in my blues, my gig line would be straight, my hat would be on correct, and that's what I learned from these incredible professionals who invested in everything they had over the last 7.5 weeks to make sure that the citizens, your sons and daughters, had what they need to be able to experience what the United States Air Force is all about. They're the ones that made sure that they understood the requirements every day, They made sure that they were there to help them succeed in our United States Air Force. They're the ones that actually launched them into their careers as they get into Airman's Week, where we reinforce everything that these MTIs have taught them, and then they get into the technical training platforms where the MTLs, our military training leaders, will take what these MTIs have done, build on it, and create the best airmen in the world's greatest Air Force. Let's give it up to our MTIs. And finally, to my wingmen, the 860 new airmen that are on this parade field. I entered the United States Air Force 26 August 1981, and just like you, I came through basic military training. I had 45 hours of college credit. I earned my first two stripes when I was at Keesler Air Force Base in technical training. I want to let all of you know that the world is at your feet. The United States Air Force is built by legends who are leaders. Every one of you need to understand that now you are part of us. You're a part of the long blue line. And every one of you can do what you need to do to become leaders, warriors, and wingmen in the world's greatest Air Force. Set your goals as high as you can. Don't settle for the standard. Set a new standard of excellence and make every single day count. That's what Bob Labruda has done over the last 35 years. And here I am now as the second Air Force commander. If you want to be Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force, do it. If you want to be a two-star general in the United States Air Force leading this command, set that goal now. Do your best every single day. Great mentors are going to make the most of your talents and lead from the front. Are you ready to join the world's greatest Air Force? Raise your right hand and repeat after me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand. General Labruda will now administer the oath of enlistment.
I state your name. Do solemnly swear or affirm that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same. That I will obey the orders of the President of the United States and the orders of the officers appointed over me, according to regulations and the Uniform Code of Military Justice. So help me God. Congratulations, Airman. You are now part of the world's greatest Air Force.
Recite the Airman's Creed and remain in place for the departure of the official party. I am an American Airman. Binnaker and Binken flight. They are followed by Blue, Roy, Cody, and Matthews flight from the 323rd Training Squadron. The last four flights are from the 324th Training Squadron. Duprat Waldo, Harlow, McKinley, and Campanelli flight. Airmen in the state flag mast Airy flight from the 322nd Training Squadron will be released to their visitors at the equipment locker to your left after they secure the flags. Airman in the Drum and Bugle Corps, Murray Flight, from the 321st Training Squadron will meet their family members at the north side bleachers near the equipment lockers after they have secured their instruments.
Oh, he's not wearing a glove. What?
Hey.
handle. Sierra.
It's still cool in there.
Hombre, que hay una turista frente al letrero.
We're going to be up all weekend long staring at people. How was it?
Ah, jeez.
Wait,
almost 1200.
And
what
did you
say? Let's go down.
Yeah,
what? We're getting food to feed him.
Here's one.
Chico, denle a los demás también.
Eso
no es una ballena. Se va a fumar la garganta.
Estoy con el get out now.
Come
Thank you.
like.
It's like when you enter SAS or something like that.
Got him now when I'm going on board.
Otra cosa.